USAF was shocked with Russia's top secret carrier killer. This was Russia's top secret project, and as a consequence, the entire United States Air Force was shocked by it. No, we are not talking about the Blackbird. Rather, we will show you something that is completely insane and also very dangerous. And this is a top secret until today. Hey intellectuals, welcome back to Vehicle Radar. In today's video, we are going to talk about the Sukhoi T-4 Sotka. So stay with us until the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. Before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started! The Sukhoi T-4 Sotka was a Soviet jet bomber prototype developed in the late 1970s. It was designed to be a long-range, nuclear-capable aircraft capable of carrying up to 40,000 kilograms of bombs. The T-4 was intended to replace the aging Tu-95 and Tu-160 bombers in Soviet service. The Soviet government issued a requirement in 1963 for the development of an aircraft similar to the North American XB-70 Valkyrie, Sukhoi, Tupolev, and Yakovlev, who were up against the T-4, Tu-135, and Yak-33. The Sukhoi design was chosen over the other two due to its high cruise speed of 3,200 kilometers an hour. The construction of a prototype was authorized in 1964. The first T-4, designated 101, took to the skies in 1972. Testing was carried out until 1974. The T-4 flew 10 times in 10 hours and 20 minutes. At an altitude of 12,000 meters, it is thought to have reached at least Mach 1.3. The second T-4 aircraft, 102, began construction in 1969 and was completed in 1973. The 102's first flight was scheduled for the end of 1973. In the end, the Soviet Air Force chose an improved version of the Tu-22 blinder, known as the Tu-22M Backfire. It was thought that modifying the blinder would be less difficult than building a new T-4 aircraft, and the project was shelved. The need to intercept the B-70, or RS-70, A-11, or A-12, and later SR-71, Hound Dog, and Blue Steel prompted the massive project in December 1962. The mission was changed early on to strategic reconnaissance and strike against major surface targets. It was also suggested that the basic air vehicle could serve as the foundation for the development of an advanced SST. There were heated debates from the start. Initially, the debate was over whether a Mach 2 aluminum aircraft could meet the requirement or whether the design speed should be Mach 3, necessitating steel and/or titanium. In January 1963, Mach 3 was chosen, along with a 6,000-kilometer design range at high altitude on internal fuel, which would be about 3,728 miles. Sukhoi, Tupolev, and Yakovlev competed with the T-4, Tu-135, and Yak-33, respectively. The Yak was too small in the TSR-2 class to meet the requirements, and the Tupolev, while resembling the B-70, was an aluminum aircraft designed for Mach 2.35. Sukhoi had always aimed for Mach 3, and its uncompromising design resulted in its selection in April 1963. This was despite the vehement opposition of not only Tupolev, but also Sukhoi's own deputy, Yevgeny Ivanov, and many of the OKB's department heads, who all saw this demanding project as an unnecessary departure from tactical fighters. Over the next 18 months, their opposition sabotaged a plan for the former Lavochkin OKB and factory to assist the T-4, and the Borevstechnik, or Stormy Gas, OKB, and the TMZ factory were appointed as Sukhoi branch offices, with the Tushino plant handling all prototype construction. From May 23rd to June 3rd, 1963, a special WS commission studied the project, and a second commission studied the refined design in February through May of 1964. The T-4 was the largest tunnel test project at CAHI at the time and by the far the largest of the Central Institute of Aviation Motors. GKAT, which is the State Aircraft Technical Committee, studied the design beginning in June 1964 and approved it in October of that year. It had outgrown its four Tumansky R-15BF-300 or Zubets RD-1715 engines by this point and was powered by four Kolosov RD-3641 engines. It was decided in January 1965 to install these all close together, as in the B-70, rather than in two pairs. From the 17th of January to the 2nd of February 1966, a mock-up review was held, with various detachable weapons and avionics pods being offered. Because its takeoff weight was expected to be 100 tons, the factory designation 100 was chosen, with a nickname Sotka, which is 100. The first flight article was number 101, and the static test specimen was number 100S. The 102, with a modified structure with more composites and no brittle alloys, was then planned for testing the new naive attack system, and the 103 and 104 for live bomb and missile test and range determination, and the 105 for avionics integration, and the 106 for clearance of the entire strike and reconnaissance system. The first article, Black 101, was transferred from Tushino to the Lil-Zhukovsky test airfield on December 30, 1971. It was accepted by the flight test crew, Vladimir Iyushin and navigator Nikolai Altryov, on April 20, 1972, and made its first flight on August 22, 1972. On flights 1 through 5, the gear was left extended, and speed was gradually increased to Mach 1.28 on flight 9 on August 8, 1973. There were no issues, though the aft fuselage tank required a steel heat shield and the hydraulics had minor issues. The WS order for 1970 through 75 included 250 T-4 bombers, for which tooling was being installed at Kazan, the world's largest aircraft factory. The program was canceled after much more debate, during which Minister P.V. Dmitriev told Marshal Grechko that he could only get his massive MiG-23 order if the T-4 was scrapped. On the 22nd of January 1974, Black 101 flew once more for a total of 10 hours and 20 minutes. The majority of the second aircraft, Article 102, which was about to fly, was donated to the Moscow Aviation Institute, while numbers 103 to 106 were scrapped. Sukhoi OKB began work on a completely redesigned and significantly more advanced successor, the T-4MS, or 200, in 1967. The cancellation of the T-4 resulted in the cancellation of even more remarkable project. Aircraft 101 was donated to the Monino Museum in 1982. Instead, the 2-22M and 2-160 were manufactured at the Kazan plant. In essence, the T-4 was a smaller-scale clone of the North American B-70. The structure was built with high-strength titanium alloys, VT-20, VT-21L, and VT-22, stainless steels VIS-2 and VIS-5, structural steel VKS-210, and soldered VNS-2 steel for fuel and hydraulic piping. The wing had an inboard leading edge angle of 75 degrees and 44 feet, which changed to 60 degrees 17 feet over the majority of the span. The thickness and chord ratio was a remarkable 2.7%. Half the tank were system compartments, which culminated in a rectangular tube housing quadruple cruciform braking parachutes. The massive box under the wing housed the air inlet systems and the four single-shaft RD-3641 turbojets, each with a 16,000 kilogram after-burning rating, which comes out to about 35,273 pounds. The nose gear used hydraulic steering as a shimmy damper and had levered suspension to two similar tires with wheel brakes, and it retracted into a space between the engine ducts. Hey, that's going to do it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed our video. If you did, please click on the like button and make sure you share it with your friends and family. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure you stay tuned for our next one. Thanks for watching.